folks, welcome back here to the Vegas Don Channel. We're on Vegas Drive, formerly Owens Avenue, just crossing over Decatur here. And that is Decatur heading south. Car wash over here, AutoZone, as well as some other auto repair shops, it looks like, and auto supply store, AutoZone. We got Fairhaven there, River of Life, Word Ministries, and a lot of apartment buildings over here on the right. I'm on the left side of the street from us. We're going to make this right here onto Leonard Lane. And watch out for this truck. Not sure what he's doing. And I wanted to show the neighborhood up in here. We had a viewer request that we come up here and take a look at this area. This is Leonard Circle. See some high cloud tops up there in the distance, but no rain in forecast for today, at least in here. This is Leonard Circle. Newer looking home there. Looks like it might need some paint or something. That's a nicer looking home, 77. And the cul-de-sac here, it looks like we're in a dead end. Turn around. And this one here is 1721. That house right there. With an old Mitsubishi Eclipse out parked out front. Used to love the Eclipse. See them in Fast and Furious movies all the time now. Cool looking car still, even today in my humble opinion. Here on Leonard Circle, we're going to go ahead and there's a plane up there just taking off from North Las Vegas Airport. Oftentimes those are trainees doing their thing up there. Make a left here onto Leonard Lane again. And have kind of some western motif here as well. Some wagon wheels on that fence there. It's just kind of a mishmash of different eras, really. Because some of these homes have been here for a lot longer than others. We have dumpsters lining the roadways here, as we do throughout a lot of the area, especially in the east side of Las Vegas. Old Suzuki Samurai there. Huh. Trash can is overflowing there. And an empty lot over here for dumpsters. Old area of town for sure. We got some walls that have been tacked over there. We're gonna go ahead and make a U-turn here just before Lake Mead Boulevard. We're gonna head back southbound here on Leonard. No trespassing, no vehicles. Right there, some cactus. Front of that home. Got some car seats sitting there. Look pretty torn up. La Margin Court is that name? I think that's another cul-de-sac. Again, there's Leonard Circle, Vegas Drive here. Got an old, what is that? I'm not sure what that is. Is it a Buick? I just can't quite tell. Got some older vehicles parked over there. That's cool. Like they tagged that wall and someone tried to cover it. We're gonna make this right back here on Vegas. Vegas Drive. Se renta. We are renting in these apartment buildings here. Wait for this truck here. Car still reads 117 degrees Fahrenheit, about 47 degrees Celsius. And we will make the right. And we're we're going to go ahead and make a left here onto Tequesta. There's a town in Florida, southeast Florida, called Tequesta. Named for the Tequesta Indians, I believe. Bounce house right there on a Saturday afternoon. That's a staple. Pebble Beach Boulevard. We're going to make a left onto Pebble Beach. Over here across the street. The apartment buildings here to our left, that's not a surprise. Yeah, you got a lot of folks, and especially with the economy what it is right now, you have a lot of folks living in one unit, and so that tends to bring a lot of other cars around too. Laurelhurst here, tire shop up there. Gonna make this right on Laurelhurst, go down another block. Looks like some newer units here. It's weird how they just put these units in right next to the older units. Some people might call that gentrification. Not me, but some people. Turn around here. Another bounce house over there. A lot of birthdays use bounce houses here in Las Vegas. Now heading northbound here, back up towards Vegas Drive. And we've got metal grates in the roadway here. Away from those. Don't trust those. We'll go back down Pebble Beach Boulevard here for a moment. Starting to get the sun effect here in the camera. Bars on windows there. So show you the other side of the street now. Here on Pebble. Pebble Beach, that is. Some really nice trucks inside some of these driveways. I can't afford a brand new truck. Got some older apartment buildings there. Basketball hoop. More handwritten building numbers. There's an old cop car. As we approach Michael Way, we're going to make a left here on the Michael Way. At one time, we read Michael Way had the most calls for service on it out of any other roadway here in this area of town. Whether that's true or not, remains true or not, I think that was right before COVID, so I don't know if that still remains true. We're going to check it out just for fun here since we're already here. Take a look at Michael. Terminate up here. just on the other side of the US 95, which is on the other side of that wall. This is Tanya Avenue. We will go ahead and try to make a U-turn here. Looks like they had some parties or something up here at night. Looks like a shopping cart. I don't know what happened there anyway. Looks like they have folks coming up here and partying or something at night, maybe. Go make this right back here on the Michael again. Now heading northbound on Michael. Homes in this area probably are going to be around $350,000, $400,000, depending upon the size. Price per square foot, I'm going to say in this area, based upon the... Look at that Amazon driver. Wow! That's a nice stop. Prices per square foot in this area are probably going to be around at least $200 a square foot. $200 a square foot. And now he's doing the speed limit. Oh, goodness. God bless the Amazon drivers. They have a stressful job as it is. Just as long as you don't hit me. St. Francis de Sales Park over here on the left. As we wait for the light here at Washington once more. And it looks like we've got the green Roman Catholic Church. Oh, it's a church, it's not a park. Right there on the left. Gotcha. Speed limit 15 in here when the school's in. No school today, it's a Saturday. We continue here on Michael. Michael? I just hear Dwight Schrute's voice every time I say that. Carmen Boulevard, we're passing over here. Back up here to the light at Vegas Drive, or Owens on the east side of town. And we'll wait our turn here, Circle K right there, on the right. And we finally got the green light here at Vegas Drive. Owens Avenue on the east side of town. Some more dumpsters lining the roadway. Here on Michael. Michael Way. See the homes lining the roadway here. We've been asked, does it snow here in Vegas? Very rarely. I think 2008 was the last time we had snow that actually stuck in the valley. You'll get it on the periphery and the kind of the foothills on the outside of the ranges of town, but it's just a dusting and it melts almost immediately, so nothing that would be that would keep you from traveling. And I wasn't here in 08, I came here in 11, but I heard there's a juice stand on the side of the road there as we approach Lake Mead Boulevard, a major east-west artery here. I read that they did shut the town down because no one knows how to drive in this stuff. It's kind of like L.A., right, where if it rains there, there's a song. It Never Rains in Southern California by Tony Tony Tone, right? That house, that's all. Front yard there. So when it does rain there, a lot of folks just don't know how to drive. I've driven in LA in the rain. It's not fun. Folks just don't know how to what to do. And approaching the light here at Smoke Ranch, which is Cary, C-A-R-E-Y, on the other side, east side of Las Vegas. Still here on Michael. Way. Seattle Slough, a drive right there. They use their imaginations here. Smoke Ranch Villas. Villas in there. Some of the neighborhoods lining Michael here. Alfred Drive. Mount Charleston's a different story when it snows, though, because when it snows up there, they close down the roads that access the mountain. And no one can get up there. It's a huge tourist attraction in the winter, especially right after Christmas. Probably during Christmas, too, really. But huge tourist attraction. A lot of folks head up that way to go play in the snow and stuff. And they had a great restaurant up there. It burned down. And now they're in the process of rebuilding it. It was nice to take a day trip up there and go hang out. Have some bison burger at the restaurant up there. But that is no longer a thing. See some apartments here up on our right. Just before Cheyenne, we'll make a right here onto, this looks like a, oh, that's a dead end, okay, never mind, on Redberry Street, make a right onto Redberry, for our friends following along at home. This road off. Wow. I wonder why that happened. We want to take a moment here real quick just to show you our new Vegas Dawn threads with our logo on top of the skyline here for the city of Las Vegas. And available through our shop section here on the Vegas Dawn channel on YouTube. We want to thank you all so very, very much for joining. We really, really appreciate all of you. And if you haven't already, please do like, follow, and subscribe to us on YouTube and other viewers on YouTube and TikTok. Thanks again for joining, folks, and we'll see you again soon. And always remember here on the Vegas Dawn channel, it's the journey. We'll see you soon.